Student evaluations. That's the topic of this video. So in this video, we're going to be looking at the evaluation process. Who provides the evaluation? What will it cover? What is it based on? How often is it? Those types of details. So let's first look at why we have an evaluation. Well, we have the evaluations, actually two of them, because of the requirement in the home ed regulation. So the home ed regulation states that each home ed student will be evaluated by a home ed teacher. We call that teacher a facilitator. So your facilitator will visit you either in your home or somewhere like Tim Hortons or a restaurant, somewhere that's comfortable for you, and will conduct the first semester evaluation with your son or daughter. And that evaluation, like I mentioned, is required by the regulation. And it's nothing though to get stressed over. The evaluation is going to cover two things, and that is, those two things are progress and achievement. So by the regulation, both of these two evaluations will look at the progress of your son or daughter and the achievements of your son and daughter. And you can know that the progress and achievement are all relative, or both relative to the program plan that you have established. So there's a real unity here, because you, the parent, because you are the authority, you create the program plan. So you determine what you're going to teach, and you also determine the scope and breadth and depth of the evaluation, because the evaluation is determined by your program plan. So your facilitator will usually come to your house, and it's should be a very low stress environment. With the, it's very low stress. If it's high stress, you might want to look at a different program. So with us, we're trying to just sit down with you, create a very calming atmosphere, and we just ask, how's it going? How is Johnny, how is Susie progressing through the goals that you set up? We don't come in, your facilitator should not be coming in with an agenda of his own or her own, or some kind of standard or some kind of grade level, anything set by the school. That is not appropriate. Again, if that's what's happening, or if that happens, I would look at changing to a different program, because these evaluations are based on your program plan that you established. So all the questions should be contained or focused on topics that are inside your program plan. This isn't an opportunity for the teacher to come in with a host of other things to look at. So again, you get to determine what the evaluation is going to cover. So with us at the, your facilitator will usually come to your house. We usually have a cup of coffee. You'll sit down. The parent, or both parents, will be with your son or daughter. The facilitator will talk to you, the parent, ask how things are going, then talk to your son or daughter. If the child's really young, obviously that's going to look differently with younger children. But the whole goal is just to very casually but intentionally look at how things are going. It's not a police visit. We're not there to catch you doing something wrong. Parents should feel very free, as they are, to say, hey, I changed the plan, or you know what, this year, this semester, this month isn't going well. We've changed our plans here or here, or we haven't achieved like we thought we would over here. We're a little behind here, or we're ahead here. We're making great progress. We're actually doing more than we thought. All those things are going to be part of the evaluation. One year, you could have a bad month here and there. Another year, you could have a great month here and there. So it's there's an ebb and flow, and your facilitator is always there to help you, support you, encourage you, offer suggestions. In the very rare occasion, the facilitator might need to say, hey, things aren't going well, and we need to look at some options. But that is so rare, so incredibly rare. I wouldn't even mention it in the video, but I did want to mention it because I need to cover everything. But that's so rare. Usually, things are going well, and it's a good opportunity to meet with your facilitator again. There's usually a good rapport between you and your facilitator. hopefully you're happy to see your facilitator. You're not stressed the night before, you know, those kind of things. So during the evaluation, your facilitator will need to see samples of what your son or daughter has done. Those samples can be a portfolio, can be as fancy as a portfolio, or it could just mean you pulling the workbooks off your shelf or wherever you keep your workbooks and just showing your facilitator samples of what your son or daughter has accomplished. To include in those things would be trophies and certificates and awards. You know, you could show a video. Some of our home ed students are really, really talented with music, public speaking, athletics. You know, you can show videos. I mean, you can be creative and make this more like a show and tell. It doesn't have to be a dry, boring kind of evaluation. I don't think you'd enjoy that. The facilitator would really enjoy seeing that, those kind of resources, as opposed to having to look at assignment workbooks and things like that. So your evaluation is to cover progress and achievement, and that can look really like an awards night. It doesn't have to be dry and boring, and again, it's not supposed to be stressful. So that happens twice a year, and it's usually in your home, and it's in person, obviously, with you, the parent, and your son or daughter. Your child does need to be present at these meetings, not for the whole meeting, but the facilitator does need to talk to your child. If your child is young, you're obviously, you're the parent, you will be, if you want, in the room with the child. So you get to kind of, you're part of that, and you can help with those questions and answers with your child, with their if they're young. But the child does need to be part of the evaluation. So that, in a nutshell, is the evaluation. Again, it's meant to be a supportive time as well, so nothing to be stressed over at all.